It's the last day of the RoboSub challenge, and the teams are weighing in their subs for the finals. Today, they'll find out if months of preparation and a week of intensive testing will pay off.
How heavy is it allowed to be?
75, I think, or 70 kilos. So, yeah, but it can be up to 75, I think. Maximum weight, qualified. Yeah.
If the subs are too heavy, the teams lose points. It's to ensure a level playing field, as they're probably packing extra sensors. The rules are strict, but everyone gets a fair chance. Cambridge is back in the race after the judges gave them one last attempt to qualify.
All right, you guys have qualified!
Yes!
Yes!
Cambridge was up late last night trying to debug its software. Insta Britannia is starting the day off in second place and unafraid of the competition.
We've been coming here multiple years. They've been coming here multiple years, so we see their projects evolve. And it is a competition, I know, but we do also want to see things succeed because it's interesting for us. And it's all in good spirit. It's really all in good spirit.
No matter what the score, everyone takes home plenty of practical experience. And NATO also benefits from interacting with students who are forced to be innovative and resourceful due to their limited budgets. But the main goal for the alliance is to encourage more young people to seek careers in engineering and research. Tamara shares this goal and particularly wants to encourage more women.
I know that in my class we were about 12% like female, so that's not much. And the numbers are going down. So I encourage all the women to come and try it out because it's a lot of fun. It seems, and plus you can meet a lot of boys.
Tamara and her team are up next. It's time to show the judges that their sub can track a pipeline and follow a harbor wall autonomously.
Time remaining is 21 minutes and 30 seconds.
Once again, it's a race against the clock. The AUV is searching for the underwater pipeline autonomously, but the visibility is particularly bad today. The pipeline is colored bright orange, and the AUV is programmed to recognize that color with its downward-facing camera.
So you search, it's looking for it, it can't find the pipeline, so.
Meanwhile, Cambridge is analyzing its attempt at tracking the pipeline. They found it, but failed to track it the whole way. Again, it's simply a matter of timing, says Ralph.
Ultimately, it's down to testing time. To get software which works really reliably, you need a long time to test it. And this year, we decided not only to create a lot more software, but to build a completely new vehicle called Barracuda. And so that meant that the vehicle was only ready for the software to test on a couple of days ago.
At last, the Insta Britannia sub looks like it's onto something.
We are performing the pipeline following, and the judges say it's going well. So we're happy right now.
The challenge is to complete all the tasks in 30 minutes without surfacing.
What it's going to do, it's going to redo wall following back to get to the, buoy. Okay.
The Insta sub manages to complete all the tasks, but the competition is strong. It's now up to the judges to tally up the score. In the end, Cambridge received the engineering award for its brand new sub. Ralph and his mates vow to return with better software next year. Insta Britannia finish in third place, just behind the University of Lübeck and this year's winners, École Technologie Supérieure de Québec.
Yes, I am. Thank you.
Well done.
Well, we ended up being third, and we're very happy with this position because, honestly, the other teams did wonderful. Sonia, the winning team, really deserved it, so we're happy. We're glad.
Finally, the organizers announced that next year's competition will be open for cooperative AUVs to help spur on the development of swarm technology. I'm Mike Mühlberger, reporting for the NATO channel from La Spezia, Italy.